Hey guys, what's up? We've got a different video for you today. We are working on a car and we're going to pull a dent out of this, as you can see there.
And we have
a little crease there. So we thought, well look, we've got our dent puller out today.
The G-Spot GD90E. Yeah, we're not sponsored by them or anything like that. It's a cheap Chinese machine. Some of these dent machines are like £500-600, maybe even more than that. I paid probably around £200 for this with a kit. So it comprises of the actual box. You get a couple of these. This tip welds onto the panel once it's been ground back and clear. That welds onto the panel and you use it as a slide hammer to pull the dent, and then you untwist, re-weld, pull. So that's the actual main machine. You hook that up, it's got a trigger for your arc. And then you've got your earth, which you've got to put on the panel that you're working on. It's quite a straightforward machine.
Yeah.
Cheap, easy to use. You can weld on these eyes, so you'd weld these onto the panel, and you could pull all that in pretty much like one big length.
Which we might try
doing. It'll save a few creases, and you either hook up your Edward Scissorhands multi-claw.
Right.
You hook onto a bar, you put a rod through all your eyes and then hook on with that. You can screw that onto the end of the slide hammer, or you can use another tool which I've got. Some different assortments that you'd use them to weld on as well, I guess. Big sucker plate that comes with it, spare tip, and a few triangle tips that come with the kit. And then we've got some carbon rods. So that when you're working, when you start pulling dents in loads of different areas, the panel can get very flexible. You touch it and it's like bonk, and then you pull it and it pops in and out. So
yeah.
You use the carbon rod, you put that directly in to the tip that way around, and you strike over the panel and it heats the panel and makes it shrink and it tightens it up.
Okay.
And stops it bouncing about, and then you can get back into your dent pulling again. Because once the panel starts flexing, you can't pull the dent. That's a basic quick rundown of it.
Nice.
I think we'll go with just the normal tool, because I'm going to have to filler this anyway. It's a bit too extensive, so you could spend a lot of time pulling all that, grind it, dye it, pull it, dye it, and you can keep going until you don't use no filler work. But this is a cheap job. I'm doing like pretty much nearly half a car. I'm doing 3/4 of a car pretty much at this rate. So
that's it, guys. That's what we're working with. So
machine.
Show you how it's done.
So make sure you wear goggles, guys.
Yeah, I've got a stamp.
I've got my built-in goggles here all the time now.
Stand back a bit so you can see the whole effect.
It's always terrifying as well with new panel. You're like, oh, it's like, it's not that bad, is it? You've got to take a grinder to it, but yeah.
Guys, that's the panel angle grinded down.
Yeah, normally you'd use a different wheel. Obviously I'm using a thin cut-off disc because I've used the grinder many a times. I don't advise you doing this on a panel, because you can, if you're not careful, you can remove a lot of material, and then when you start trying to weld on it, you end up ripping it off.
Yeah.
So you have to be careful you're not grinding too much in one area.
Yeah,
so
just feather it through.
Yeah, you'd use a fibre one of these. It's more ideal if you're not you know, Andy with a grinder.
Let's
plug the G spot in.
Hey, this is what happens, guys, when you turn it on. It turns red.
It's been a while since I've used this. Manual selection, because that's what we want.
We're going to go
for earth, which is one of these. I think it'll be five, so tools, need to press that button. Five, that selects tool five, which you want to use, and then the power of it, putting on an earth, so we'll go with half power. Five is half. So now, let's get the earth on, because it's a welding tool. So, buzz, now that's stuck on there. So wind that onto the panel, and it stops it flexing about, so that should stay there now. So, that's the earth attached. So now we're going to be going with the triangle end. Triangle end is tool number one. You can see it's got the triangle symbol there,
right.
Number one, so we need to press that down to one on tools, input, five power, we'll stick with five power.
Right.
That'll be pretty sufficient, I would think. Pulling that in. Re-end my thing here. Battered. Say to work from the outside of a dent to the inside. Now personally I end up like, yes, if your intention is to not use filler, then you would start from the outside and gradually bring the dent up from out to in.
Yeah.
So it stays more level and you end up the less risk of warping the panel when it flexing and having to use the carbon rod, like I said.
Yeah.
So, because I'm using filler, I know I'm going to be using filler, I just go straight down the middle, I graze it as much as possible just to reduce how much filler I'm using. That is the only intention. So yeah, there's right and wrong ways of doing this. And, you know, I am doing it wrong by going straight down the middle, but I know I'm using filler, so just going to go straight in with it.
guys. It's a marked improvement.
Sorry guys.
A little spark goes running a fucking mile.
Yeah, I wasn't expecting it. Oh dear guys.
Yeah, the second one's got to go in a little bit. Dress that in, it's not a problem. That's the rough gist anyway, guys. You can see it's come out a hell of a lot. Some bits are high, some bits are low. I do need to go over it again, but
yeah, that at least the dent has been pulled.
That's it, yeah, it has been reduced.
Yeah, it's definitely a hell of a difference. I know it might not seem that way on camera, guys, but dent's not there anymore, it's not folded in.
Yeah, that's it, it's definitely a lot straighter. It's a little bit too high. Definitely, I need to tap it back down in places, but I need to get a ruler out and stuff like that. But I've got to go and pick up a bike from MIT now, so.
Alright guys, no worries, but that's it. That's how you use a dent puller anyway. and that's with the Spot 6090 dampener. So yeah guys, we'll quickly show you that. There you go. Yeah, so thanks guys, make sure you stay tuned, like and subscribe, and we're done. Peace.